Welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy VII. So last episode we went into this room over here. There were some tough enemies, but we got through it, and we got some sweet new equipment. Now off screen I went back in there and fought a couple more enemies. As you can see, I leveled up each character, I think once, maybe twice for Cloud, not sure. But something crazy happened. I mastered like a bunch of materia. Like I wasn't even trying, but let me see if I can show you. Not that one. Here, let me just see if I can find the ones that I mastered. Here's a couple. We got some restores right there. And I mastered 3 all materia. Like, that's crazy. 3 all materia. So, I wasn't even expecting to do that, but then I did, so. Everything's all arranged in the way that I want it, and, we're all set to explore the rest of this, sunken plain, and we're gonna go to the left now. And it's the Turks. Also, that hand is, the hand is pointing, like, upside down. Okay. Turks. Again. We just seem to keep running into each other lately. How are you guys like here in the sunken plain? Like, this is such an obscure place to run into you. There were weapons and materia developed solely to destroy Sephiroth, but it was attacked by weapon and sunk to the bottom of the sea. I can't give you what's here. We'll take out Sephiroth. I guess this is our last meeting. I won't let you get in our way. Alright, boss fight. Good thing I'm pretty much all prepared. Yuffie is missing like 10 HP, but whatever. I guess I'll try like Ultima or something. Cut, yeah, that seems good. Deathblow, yeah, I have everyone all like really optimized, I guess you could say. Yeah, I have everything set up as if I was gonna fight a boss, because I was kind of expecting it. Let me see. I guess I'll do this again. And you know what? Let's just go ahead and do barrier. That seems like a good idea. These guys are pretty tough. Well, we are pretty tough. Yeah, so since I maxed out some restore materia, pretty much I just put on some lower level ones, because I was like, well, these are maxed out, so I'm only gonna use them if I need to, because otherwise it's like I could be leveling up other materia. So yeah, that's pretty much what I was doing. Okay, Root is just like lots of dots and then he leaves. Oh, that was it? I expected that to be hard. That was super easy. We sure did get a lot of stuff. Wow. Okay. Elixir. Got a lot of level ups and materia level ups and everything. So Shinra's new secret weapon was on this airship. Maybe it's still here. But right now, I just want to check out what exactly did we level up? That. Yeah, what exactly was it? Yep, there we go. Another all materia completely leveled up. I honestly don't know what happens when you get to 5 stars, because I know like if you have 1 or 2 or 3 stars, it like limits how many times you can use the all materia. But once it gets to 5, like what does it even do? Not too sure. Also, I think we leveled up the time materia. Oh yeah, so now we have haste, slow, and stop. So that could be useful. Alright, enough messing around in there. Let's see what's in this room. This must be the cargo room. Alright, and I see a treasure chest. Megalixir. Alright, those are good. I'm pretty sure. This is terrible. It's all messed up. Ooh, I see a summon materia. Give it to me. Hades materia. Ooh, I wonder if that's good. Probably, since you have to go really out of your way to get it. Let's see. Which one's like the weakest? Probably this one. Alright, let's see. Does this help? I don't think it does. Let's see, it has magic, magic defense, minus HP, and plus max MP. You know what, I guess this Hades Materia is pretty good for boosting the stats, except for HP, which is now lower, but I have higher magic defense, so you know what, maybe I'll be fine. Plus we get to try out a new thing. Alright, let's see what else is in here. Lots of treasure. I can see there's lots of treasure. And another one of these things. Yeah, I fought a couple of these off screen before. Not really much of a problem. The Deathblow Materia has come in so much handy. I'm glad I found it like early in the game. Cause is there only one in the game? And you have to find it at a certain point. Also, Cloud has a thing equipped to him so he doesn't get that status effect of like confuse, I think what it is. And Tifa has the nullify all status effect thing. Man, can't talk right now. Yeah, this guy's just kind of annoying. Did we fight one of these last episode? I can't remember. Cause like I don't want to just like keep showing the same fights over and over again. It feels like this guy is taking longer to kill than usual, which is kind of weird. Cause like I remember fighting a whole bunch of these guys the other day. All right, yeah, that still was not too bad. We hardly lost any HP. All right, and we cut a lunar curtain. I don't even know what that is. I fought a whole bunch of them. Never even got that. Okay, let's see what that is. Lunar curtain. I just really want to know what it is. It's gotta be somewhere. Oh, there it is. Creates M barrier around all allies. Alright. I guess that's something. Let's see what's here. Received Outsider. That sounds like it would be a weapon for Vincent. I'm wondering if I'm right. That would be so funny if I was right. Outsider. How did I guess? How did I guess? I swear I have not played this game before. Like, I promise, this is still a blind Let's Play. I just actually guessed that. Highwind. Wait, Highwind? Like, the ship that we go on? Okay. Highwind. Learn limit skill Highwind. I'm guessing that's for like Cid, maybe? Alright. I don't see too much else here. We can't go in the water. I think there's one more treasure chest up there. But then after that, I think we're pretty much done with this sunken area. And we got another thing to fight. We fought one of these last episode. It's probably gonna die real fast. Ow. Sometimes when like my character gets hit, it feels like I get hit, but not really. I guess it's just an instinctual thing to say ow. And not much damage. Man, I have not even had to heal yet. Maybe I leveled up too much. I mean, I only got like one or two level ups, but like, it's so weird. Between one and two level ups, you go from, oh no, these guys are so tough, to, yeah, this isn't a problem at all. Like, it makes such a big difference for some reason. Alright, so yeah, we got a new thing. It sounded like a weapon for Cid. Yep, it is. Yeah, I could tell. Whoa. Alright, so yeah, I just remembered what to do. I went to go look at the one of the last videos I recorded, and they didn't really tell me what to do, but then I saw the thumbnail of the old guy at the City of the Ancients, and I was like, oh yeah, I have to go to that city. So yeah, I indirectly reminded myself. So it should be somewhere up in these mountains, if I recall. It's around here. There we go. Yeah, and for some reason we can land down here, even though it's not green. And, oh, guess I should get off my chocobo. Alright, yeah, let's go and consult with the old man. If I can remember how to get to him. I'm pretty sure it's just like a straight shot to that room with the thing. Ah, it kind of looks like a fountain. I don't know exactly what it is. And hopefully we don't run into any enemies, because if we do, they're going to be like super weak enemies and just waste our time. Man, is it here? Or should I have taken a left? I can never remember these things. Normally I have to play through a game several times before I remember where things are. Yeah, I don't believe this is it. Pretty sure. Alright, we should have taken the other way. Oh, I feel dumb. I feel like I'm wasting people's time, but at the same time, people are like, no, we want like a genuine blind playthrough where we see your mistakes and such. And then some people are like, no, if you're a good Let's Player, you cut out all the junk. So you have to find a balance. You have to show your stupid moments, but cut out the stupid moments that are boring. I guess that's how it works. It's such a long pathway. Like, I'm pretty sure the way they do that effect is just, they like just make you move really slowly. Like, that's probably all it is. Like, you're not actually moving that far away. It's probably just shrinking the model and then like making you go slower, but still keeping the same running animation. I don't know, that's just what I think they did. Alright, so I forgot to silence my cell phone. So yeah, let's talk to the old guy. This recording session is a mess. Oh, you found it. Yes, I did. It's giant, so I don't know how we got it in here. Also, excuse me, sir, we're overlapping each other in the third dimension. That music box over there, we'll put the key in it. I'll go use the key. You wait here. Watch closely what happens. Man, it sure did shrink. It kind of looks like the, what is it? The animas in Xenogears? Like the original ones, not the one in Xenosaga. Because they're like kind of different. Or no. The ones in Xenosaga kind of look like that. The one in Xenogears just look like smaller Zohars. Whatever, nobody knows what I'm talking about. Alright, so what happens? Put the key in the keyhole and... Okay, we're just gonna flood the city. No. Maybe that was a fountain. Filling the fountain up? What's going on here? Now go inside. Hope it might be inside. Oh, so it's like a portal? Powered by water? This was just a screen projected... A screen to project an image. Look at the image projected on the screen of water. Alright, what does it show? What is it? I have no idea what I'm looking at. Oh. There's Eris. Did she, like, leave behind, like, a video message for us or something? Okay, so she had a materia that she dropped in the water. In the water right below us, apparently? Alright, so I guess let's go for a swim. I guess that materia is important. Like, maybe it cancels out Meteor? It's glowing. It's pale green. Eris already prayed for Holy. After I gave up the black materia to Sephiroth, Eris' words came into my dreams. She said she was the only one who could stop Sephiroth, and to do that, there was a secret here. That was holy. That's why she had the white materia. Eris knew about here and what she had to do. Eris left us great hope, but it cost her life, her future. Sorry, Eris. I should have figured this out sooner. You left without saying a word. It was all so sudden, I couldn't think. And that's why it took so long for me to find out. But, Eris, I understand now. I'll do the rest. Not I, Dorcas, we. What Eris left us, we shouldn't waste. Yeah, let's go for a swim. Eris' voice has already reached the planet. Just look at the glow of the white materia. But how about Holy? How come Holy isn't moving? Why? Something's getting in its way. There's only one that could do that. Sephiroth, where are you? What, is he here? Or, okay, I'm just gonna talk to you again. Except I can't, so I'll just leave. Alright, so where do I go now? Do I... Oh, the old man's gone. What? Is he like in my party again? That's weird. Alright, so let's... Oh. Okay, cell phone call. What the? Whisper, whisper. Sorry, I was a little surprised. What happened? Remember when Junian Cannon disappeared? Actually, Rufus moved it. Moved it? That big thing? Where and why? Rufus wants to destroy Sephiroth with it. Well, it sure is a giant cannon. Might work. That cannon operates on huge materia, but the huge materia has already been used in the rocket plan. So since the cannon's useless right now, he decided to move it. To a place where materia, no, Mako is gathered. So he's gonna like hook it up to a Mako reactor? And where is that? Oh, cutscene, something's going on. Helicopters. Everybody panic. Wait, the back propeller on those helicopters aren't moving. I don't think that's how aerodynamics work, but alright. I could be wrong, I don't really know anything about helicopters, so maybe the back propeller isn't supposed to move most of the time. Oh man, that's Midgar. I hooked it up to the Midgar reactor. Reeve, it's your job to adjust the reactor's output. I see. Don't worry about adjusting it. Once you've opened it up all the way, everything will go full speed. The president's sure done it this time. The whole idea that meteor will disappear if we defeat Sephiroth is all wrong. If you remember, Mr. President, it was my idea to fire Mako-powered shells. Will the shells really reach the northern border? I don't know, maybe. Of course. I mean, we gotta test it to find out. Can't know for sure. But Mr. President, let's not call it a Mako cannon. The new weapon is called... the Sister Ray. Okay. Any particular reason? Alright. Well, I guess we're going back to Midgar. That's where the party's going on, is in Midgar. Alright, I think I'm just gonna cut ahead to the High Wind, because you don't want to see me walk all the way there. What? What? Cloud? What? Someone talking to me? Whoa, what the? I just hopped on my chocobo and then suddenly cutscene. Oh, are they firing the cannon now? Kinda thought I could get there first. Oh, it's one of those weapons. White weapon, maybe? Or silver weapon? I don't know what it would be called. Moving slowly towards the city. Yeah, looks like you're not gonna get to use it on Sephiroth. You should probably use it on that thing. I mean, you took out, like, what was it? Sapphire weapon or whatever? Like, you blew off its head before, so... could probably beat that thing. What's wrong? It's a strange signal. From where? It's coming from this person. Question mark. Sure is descriptive. Wow. Hey. What are you doing? That was a surprise. The controls went crazy. This ain't good. Weapon came out of the sea and is heading straight for Midgar. The new weapon should stop him, right? The new weapon will stop weapon. I don't know if it's ready or not. What's gonna happen to Marlene? Yeah, she's still in the city. Don't you worry, Nun. Marlene's in a safe place. She's with Aeris' mom. But they're still in the city, so... if the city blows up, it doesn't matter who they're with. What is that screeching just now? As long as the materia is safe, who cares what else happens, right? I've been itching to say this to you for a while now. When you blew up Sector 1 reactor, how many do you think died? I don't know, this place seemed kinda empty, maybe just a few. That was for the life of the planet. You gotta expect a few casualties. Yeah, I mean, it was blow up the reactor or let the planet blow up, so I mean, it wasn't too much of a bad decision. A few, what do you mean a few? What may be a few to you is everything to those who died. That's true too. Protect the planet. That sure sounds good. And no one will go against you. So do you think you can do whatever you want, right? Why are you bringing this up now? That was like 50 hours of gameplay ago. I don't want to hear that from no one in Shinra. Can't do anything about that. Stop it. Yeah, why are you fighting, like, so randomly? This is not the time for that. We gotta blow up that weapon guy. Barrett, he knows what he did. Alright, what we did in Midgar can't be forgotten, no matter what the reason. Right? We haven't forgotten, right? I know you. You can't quit the company because you're worried about the people in Midgar, right? Cloud. Yeah, Cloud, what are we gonna do? Okay, let's go. We'll beat Weapon ourselves. So it's a boss fight then. Hey, Cloud, you think we can go win against that monster? We got any chance of winning, right? How would I know? Well, if it's anything like when I tried fighting Emerald Weapon, might not go so good. But that's no reason for us to just let him go. Go into Midgard and fight the weapon. Come on, let's move. Alright, well you're gonna let me save first because I've been recording for quite some time. I mean, I'm gonna probably cut out a lot of it, but that's gonna be it for this episode. Thank you all for watching. We got some decent story progress, we got some sweet new equipment, a new materia, and everything worked out good. So I'll see you all next time.